In this video, I'm going to show you how to share a folder in Windows Server 2022 so that users can access their files over the network, because after all, that's what networks are all about. They're all about sharing resources. I'll also point out a few things to avoid and give you a few tips along the way. So here's a quick overview of what we'll cover in this video. We'll begin by creating a folder to share. We'll then set some permissions to access the folder. Then we'll create a network share to enable users to access the folder over the network. We'll set some share permissions to access the share and finish off by connecting to the share as a user. So if you're ready, grab yourself a cup of coffee or maybe a nice cup of tea and let's go over to the lab and get started. Okay, I've signed into my Windows 2022 server. And the first thing I'm going to do is create a folder, the folder that I'm eventually going to share over the network. Now you'll notice that I have two drives. This is because I've partitioned the disk. It has a system drive, drive C, and this is where the Windows Server operating system files live. And I also have a logical drive, drive E, to store user data. And this is where I'm going to create my shared folders. Now, it's really important to keep the Windows Server operating system and an organization's data separate from each other. This stops things from getting messy, it's better for security, and it'll be less of a problem should the OS need to be reinstalled. So I'm going to create my folder, call it Courses, and I'm going to create a subfolder in there, Windows Server 2022, and I'm also going to populate that with a couple of text files. Course notes, I'll just pop a bit of text in there. And we'll save that. And we'll create one more text file, call that skills test. Save that. Now that we've created a courses folder, a subfolder, and some files, the next thing we need to do is set some permissions to limit access to the folder and its contents. Now, when we share a folder in Windows Server, we're pretty much always going to be working with two types of permissions. These are NTFS permissions and share permissions. Now, NTFS permissions are applied to files and folders. They control who can access files and folders and the type of access. NTFS permissions are also more advanced than share permissions. Now, I have a whole video that covers NTFS permissions if you want to learn more about them, and I'll leave the link below in the description. Now, the other type of permissions that we need to know about are share permissions. Share permissions control access to a shared resource over the network, in our case, a shared folder. And share permissions are also more basic and they're applied to folders. So we have two types of permissions working together, basic share permissions and the more advanced NTFS permissions. So this is how it all fits together. Users connect to the share over the network. The basic share permissions are applied. The share connects the user to the folder and its contents, where the more advanced NTFS permissions are then applied. Okay, so let's configure some NTFS permissions for the courses folder. Now, it's a good idea to do this before sharing the folder because you can put more advanced security permissions in place before making the folder available to users over the network. So what we need to do is right-click the folder and choose Properties, and click the Security tab. I'm going to click Advanced, and we can already see that we have some pre-populated groups and permissions here. Now, I don't want to inherit all of these permissions, so I'm going to disable inheritance. I'm going to convert inherited permissions to explicit permissions, and I'm going to tidy up the permissions. I'm going to remove users, and I'm going to remove creator owner. but I'm going to keep the system group and the administrators group. Okay, I'm now ready to assign some new NTFS permissions, and I already have two test student accounts created called Alan and Joan, and I want them to be able to access the courses folder, but I only want them to be able to read the folder contents and execute files. I don't want them to be able to make changes or to delete things. So I need to click Add, select a principal. I'm going to type in Joan, my first user, check name, and click OK. We check the type of permission, which is allow, and this applies to this folder, subfolders, and files. And I need to make sure read and execute, list folder contents, and read is clicked, and click OK. And I'm going to do the same for my test student, Alan. Click Add, select Principal. Type Allow, this folder, subfolders, and files. Make sure Read and Execute, List Folder Contents, and Read are selected. And again, click OK. But just before I do that, notice you can actually set more advanced permissions by toggling the Show Advanced Permissions link. Let's quickly review the permissions for Joan and Alan. They're allowed read and execute permission to the courses folder, its subfolders, and files. However, assigning permissions to individual users in this way is okay in the test lab environment where we only have a few users, but for a large production network with hundreds or thousands of users, things will become unmanageable very quickly. So this is where groups come in. Instead of assigning permissions to individual users, it's better to assign permissions to a group and then add users to the group instead. Now, Joan and Alan are members of a group I've already created called Students. So all I need to do is add the Students group and assign permissions to the group instead. We do this the same way by clicking Add, select a principal, Students, check names, type allow, and again we assign read and execute, list folder contents, and read permissions, and click OK. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is remove the individual accounts for Joan and Alan now that I've added the students group. So that's student permissions configured. Next, I want to add course instructors to be able to access the courses folder. So I'm going to go to Add and type in the instructors group. Type Allow, this folder, subfolders, and files. Now I want course instructors to be able to add files and folders, modify them, and delete them as well. Now often people are tempted to assign full control. Now unfortunately this is a common mistake. Full control enables users to change file and folder permissions and also take ownership of them. Now these are tasks typically performed by administrators. So if we want instructors to be able to add files and folders, modify them and delete them, the modify permission will do all of that. So I'm going to take away full control, just leaving modify and the permissions below it. I'm going to click OK, apply those permissions, and click OK. Okay, now that we've configured NTFS permissions for the courses folder, we need to make it accessible to users over the network. And to do that, we need to share the courses folder. So we need to click the Sharing tab, Advanced Sharing, click Share this folder. We need to give the share a name. I'm going to keep the suggested name of courses. And then the next thing we need to do is assign share permissions. Now, share permissions control who has access to the shared folder over the network and also the type of access they have. Now, remember, share permissions are much more basic. and they can only be applied to a shared folder. And this is the reason they're combined with NTFS permissions, to enable us to assign more precise permissions. Okay, so let's now configure our share permissions. Now you'll notice the default share permission is to assign the everyone group read permission to the shared content, which is not good. We want to avoid assigning permissions to the everyone group because we don't want everyone accessing the share. So I'm going to remove the everyone group. Now instead, I'm going to add a group called domain users to limit access to domain user accounts. And I'm going to assign domain users change permission. Change permission allows users to create, modify, and delete content. Now, because share permissions are more basic, the options we have available are read, change, which means create, modify, and delete content, and full control permissions. And again, it's a good idea to avoid assigning full control permissions unless absolutely necessary. Okay, so we've configured NTFS permissions for the folder courses. We've shared the folder by creating a share called courses, and we've assigned share permissions. So let's test the shared folder by signing into a Windows workstation as a user and connecting to the courses share. Okay, so let's sign in as Alan. To access the courses share, I'm going to open the run command box, and we need to specify the UNC address. This is the path of the network share, which takes the form of 2 backslashes, followed by the server name, which is server 1, followed by a single backslash, and then the name of the share, which in our case is courses. And we're connected to the courses share. Okay, let's see if we can create a new text file. Now, when we do this, we receive an error message: destination folder access denied. You need permission to perform this action. Now, this is because the students group that Alan is a member of was assigned read and execute permission only, which prevents us from creating new files. Now, if we navigate to the Windows Server 2022 folder, I'm able to open the course notes file. And I'm also able to open the skills test file. Now, this is because we assigned read and execute permission to the students group. So all is good. Let's now quickly take a look at what happens if I sign in as the user IT taster, who is a member of the instructors group. I've signed in as the user IT taster this time, so let's test if we can connect to the share. And all is good there. I'm going to see if I can create a new text file as well. And this time we can, no access denied message. And this is because the user IT taster is a member of the instructors group, and we assign that modify permission. So I'm just going to give the file a name. And I'm also going to enter some text. And save the file. And no issues there either. If I go into the Windows Server 2022 folder, I'm able to access the course notes file and also the skills test file. So we've configured the share and we've tested it and all is good. However, there's one more important point that we need to cover. Very often we need to assign NTFS permissions that are different to the share permissions we've assigned, just as we have in this lab. And this can cause some confusion. So here's a quick recap of the scenario we covered in the lab. In the lab, we configured NTFS permissions for the courses folder and assign the students group, a group Joan and Alan belong to, read and execute permissions. Now, we also configured share permissions for the courses share and assign domain users, a group Joan and Alan also belong to, change permission. We have a situation where share and NTFS permissions conflict. So the question is, what permissions do Joan and Alan actually have? Well, fortunately, there's an easy rule to remember to give us the answer. When share and NTFS permissions conflict, the most restrictive permission wins. The most restrictive permission is read and execute. Therefore, the resulting permissions for Joan and Alan are read and execute. Let's look at one more scenario where share and NTFS permissions conflict, but this time I want you to see if you can work out what the resulting permission is. We have a user, John, who is a member of the domain users group. And John is also a member of the help desk group. John connects to the ticket share. The share permissions are configured as domain users group read, and the NTFS permissions are configured as help desk group modify. So the question is, what is the resulting permission, the actual permission the user John has to access the tickets folder? Have a think about it, pause the video if you need to, and leave the answer below in the comments. Well, knowing how to share folders in Windows Server 2022 is a really important skill to have. Well, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please remember to give it a like and share it. And if you want to learn more, check out this video next.